Dad, I need to tell you something.
What is it?
Well, I kinda, sold the game.
My dad slept!
The word punishment is simply defined as the infliction or imposition of a penalty as retribution for an offensive act. Or as black people say, an ass whooping. Now, different races punish their kids in different ways. But I feel you, I've seen the comments. Hispanics say they get whooped way more than black. Black people saying they have it harder than whites. Asians saying they got it the worst. Well, I say it really doesn't matter because we all getting our ass beat. Now, in my household, the choices were plenty. Think of it as the multiple choice exam. But this time, the choice is yours. Would you rather A, get whooped by a switch, B, get hit by a bell, C, get disciplined with an extension cord, D, get drilled by a hanger, or E, all of the above? Now, from my recollection, the closest object was usually the initial choice, but it also mattered how bad the action was. For example, you forget to do your chores, you better duck, my boy. And guess what does five fingers say to your face? Slap! Just think about it. You ever seen a black kid talk back to their parents?
Son, hand me that remote.
What? Man, I'm tired of this. You know what, old man? How about you get it your damn self? Oh, you about to meet Jesus. Now, I know you feel me on this one. Parents are always calling you to do something they could have easily done by themselves, but you gotta do it. Why? Because they said so. Now, I know to some people, this must sound like child abuse, which I couldn't disagree more. I can firmly say I've never been abused. Each time my parents whooped me, it's because I did something wrong. My parents' only objective was teaching me good from bad. Simply put, there's consequences to your actions. So for this story, I'ma take you back to my preteen years. So one day I was playing outside with the homies. Now on this particular day, my friends and I were having an argument on who got the best gaming console. Now here's the problem. See, at the time, I only had the Nintendo 64, which was one of the cheapest consoles to purchase since the PlayStation 2 was the hottest console at the moment. So we started arguing. Yo, Tim, what you got? Oh, me? Well, I don't want to brag and all, but I got the N64. Yeah! You still got that old broke-ass console? Damn, y'all broke. I bet you still get free lunch from school, don't you? Now, for those of you who don't know, the PlayStation 2 cost $300 at the time, and at an inflation, should be about $476 in today's world. Now, I'm sure I don't have to explain to you that asking my hard-working parents for a new PlayStation console while I already had a comparable N64 wasn't going to work, so I had to eat these jokes. Damn, all my homies got a PS2. I don't even have a PS1. So fast forward, I get to the crib and ask my mom. Hey mom, can I get a new gaming console?
New gaming console? What's wrong with the one your dad bought you?
Nothing. It's just old.
Look son, we don't have any money right now. When we have more money, we'll talk about it, okay?
Okay. So I get to my room and started thinking. All right, Tim. Everyone's school's got the PlayStation, so maybe you should trade all your games, get money, and buy the new PlayStation. So the next day I get up, get my N64 and all my games, get to the flea market, and started looking for a place to trade my games. So after a while, I see a sign on the wall. Sign says, games for trades. Okay, cool. Exactly what I was looking for. So I get closer to the counter and see a close for lunch sign. Damn, they're going for lunch. Guess I'll just sit here and wait. So a few moments go by, and an older man walks up to me. Hey kid, can I help you? Yeah, I'm looking to trade all my games.
Oh really? Let me take a look.
So I hand the guy the games.
Oh, these are nice.
All right kid, how about $200 for them?
Really?
Sure kid. So I give him the games, he goes to the side, and comes back with a big stack of 20s, and hands it to me.
I'm rich!
Thanks a lot, sir.
No. Thank you.
So I get outside and start walking to the crib. Then halfway through the journey, I decide to open a stack so I can count up my money. Nigga, this fool put $20 on the top and nothing but blank white papers underneath. Oh, hell no. So I turn around, look back, and the man was gone. Oh, no. Where'd he go? So I look to the left and I don't see him. I look to the right, man's not in sight. Oh dear God, this ain't good.
So my only option was to stand inside the store and wait for the store owner to come back. A few moments later, the owner walks into the store.
Hello, son. Can I help you?
Yeah, I'm looking for the man who works here.
I work here.
No, the other guy.
Son, what other guy? I work here alone.
Then it hit me. Oh my God. I've been scammed. What am I gonna tell my dad? I lost all my games and got nothing to show for it. So I get to the crib, got to my room, and waited for my last moments on this earth. So a day goes by, but my dad hadn't noticed it.
Alright, Tim, maybe you should go to the store and get him back by shoplifting a new N64. That way, Pops won't notice it.
Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do this weekend when the flea market opens. So right before going to bed, my Pops walks in.
Hey, son, I noticed your video game's missing.
Yeah, Dad. I let my friend Chris borrow it.
Son, that game cost me a lot of money, so bring it back tomorrow, okay?
Okay, Dad.
What do I do?
I gotta find a way to stall for the next couple of days. So day number two comes.
Hey, son, did you get back your video game?
No, Dad. See, Chris wasn't in school today. I'll get it back tomorrow.
Get it back tomorrow, okay?
Then day number three comes.
Son, I thought I told you to get the game.
Sorry. I got a little busy with some homework.
Now by day number three, my dad was getting a little suspicious. Tim, go get it now.
Okay, Tim, be cool and act like you're going to get it.
So I get outside, walk to my homie's Chris's house, knocked on the door, and started acting like I'm asking for my game back.
Yo, Chris, thank God you're home, kid. I need a favor.
Damn, Tim, you look like you saw a ghost. What's up?
Look, whatever you do, don't look at my house. My pops is outside the window looking right now. Kid, I need to borrow your N64.
What? My Nintendo?
Yeah.
Sorry, kid. I can't do that. My mom's in the living room right now.
Chris, nigga, help me. I need you.
Damn, I can't do it right now.
Chris, we're supposed to be boys.
Boy, you ain't about to get me whooped. But Chris, bye.
So, I turned back. And from the look of my dad's eyes, I knew I'm beyond dead.
Now, I've never been one to shy away from danger, but I can honestly say this is the first time in my life when I was like, nigga, I think it's better you don't go back home.
So before making my next move, my dad comes outside and calls me to the crib.
So where's the game?
Dad, I need to tell you something.
What is it?
Well, I kinda, sold the game.
My dad slapped the soul out of me.
You did what? Do you know how much money I spent on those games? I'm sorry, Dad. Sorry. You know what? You're gonna get whooped for every dollar I spent.
What's up, world? Thank you for joining your boy for another video. This week's video was about that whooping, like, and part two is dropping this week too, my guy. So stay tuned. Oh, it gets crazy. Now let's get straight to the shout out. This week's first shout out goes to the kid, Daniel. What's up, my guy? I see you all the way from Vail, Arizona. Okay, dog. Well, keep doing your thing, fam. Follow the kid on IG as not._Dan. Second shout out goes to the homie, DJ Pluto. What's up, kid? I see you. Okay, we got a YouTuber in the building. Follow the kid on IG as DJ Dogrim and on YouTube as Clueless. Keep doing your thing, bro. And last shout out goes to my man Jay Austin. What's up, dog? Mr. Continental. Okay, fam. Well, follow the homie on IG as Continental_91. Keep doing your thing, bro. If you want a chance to win a shout out, subscribe to the channel, follow your boy on IG, and send me that screenshot. As always, live free.